And brand new at 8 o'clock, how the retirement plans have been turned upside down, both for those who wanted to retire and now they can't, and then those who were forced into early retirement because of the pandemic. We're here with Colorado's own financial expert, Jordan Schwartz. Jordan, it's good to see you. I haven't seen you Hello. In quite a long time.
Ken, it's great to see you. I love Chris, but we've just got a special bond.
Hey. That is very true. I mean, we like Chris, yeah, but. We always end with a yeah, but. And you got glasses on, too, so we know how smart you are. Walk us through what this looks like for those who are heading towards retirement or those who are now forced into retirement. What do they need to do to try and protect their savings?
Well, there's no way to sugarcoat it right now. You know, the coronavirus has wreaked havoc on people's portfolios. What I can say is that we don't have to repeat the past of what we did before this. We can correct the ship and move forward in a much better direction. Biggest thing folks can do out there right now is make sure that their portfolio has a proper asset allocation, meaning how their money's mixed around. See, the reason why so many people have struggled through this time in their portfolio is they only had like two investments in their portfolios. Stock funds and bond funds. So it's making sure you've got a much more well-balanced and diversified portfolio where, you know, some folks are having to work maybe another 1 to 3 years when they were planning on retiring in the next couple coming months.
Now, Yahoo Finance just did a big article and they released it saying by the year 2024, nearly 25% of those in the workforce will be 55 and over, but that could significantly change by COVID-19. So how does that shift in the landscape work, and how do people take in all that information?
Well, there's less jobs right now, which is not a good thing, but at least the population is aging some to the point where there's not going to be as much competition for those jobs. I think it may force some people into retirement a little bit earlier. Maybe they have to change their lifestyle, but I work with retirees all the time. It's awesome. They get to relax and enjoy the fruits of their labor over a 30 or 40 year work history. The one positive element that we can look at is that, yes, some of the jobs that existed before COVID, they won't be around, but there's going to be new jobs that are created as we move into this different economy. So obviously, it's easy to get focused on the headlines and look at all the negativity right now. Obviously, we can't neglect our portfolios, but we also need to keep in mind that positive things will come after this ends.
Now, quickly, Jordan, we're running out of time. You know how we like to talk finances, and you and me, we could go on and on. For those who have looked at their retirement portfolios and they've seen it drop and they're also seeing it come back, what's your advice to them? Should they start to shift it around or try and hold on to what they've got going?
It's so tough to say because we don't have a crystal ball. You know, a lot of times in economic downturns, there's just not one bottom. Sometimes there's what's called a double bottom, meaning that it falls and rises and falls again. What I would say is that if you're within 10 years from retirement, I don't know if you should necessarily be shifting and moving things around, but I would be talking with somebody, doing a lot of research to make sure that what you have is where it needs to be, especially if we do see a double bottom in the next coming months.
That is good advice, Jordan. We appreciate it. Good to see you sometime. We'll bring you back into the studio. What do you mean?
What's with the glasses?
We all have glasses on. We all need to see.
Nice.
Strategic Wealth Designers gives us advice every Wednesday. At least me and Jordan have both of the legs on our glasses here, so it hooks around our ears. If you have money questions, you know where to send them. Send them to tips@kwgn.com, and we will forward those on to Jordan.